Hi, welcome to episode 3 of the Ticket Punks Gig Guide Review channel. I hope you've enjoyed the last video, and certainly the first video. If you've not caught any of our videos before, what Ticket Punks is about is we're a community. We're trying to give you pre-sales and information about gigs, where you can go, where you can eat, where you can park, as well as getting access to the tickets before a Friday. We're wanting you to beat the rush like we do. Don't be the 9 o'clock Friday morning Ticketmaster guy. Be someone else. Other bad ticket companies are available as well as Ticketmaster, though, so don't just go to them. This time, we've got Billy joining us. Billy's here to talk about a band he went to see recently. First of all, Billy, tell us a bit about yourself. How long have you been going to gigs?
So I've been going since about I was 14, so that's probably about 9 years ago now.
Okay. And what was your first gig that you went to that you're happy to tell everybody about?
The first proper gig was, well, wasn't allowed in, however I got in. It was the Gaslight Anthem at the HMV Picture House.
All right.
Which obviously isn't there anymore.
Aye, I know. Another loss of a great venue in Edinburgh, that one. So, this gig that you went to see, who did you go and see?
It's Frank Carter and the Rattlesnakes.
Okay. Tell us a bit about Frank Carter. There'll be people listening from various genres of music, so they might not know what Frank's about. So tell us a little bit about it.
He's sort of punk metal. It's hard to describe. It's like... Okay. Not too heavy, but not too, like, chill, if you get me, either.
Yeah, I think I know what you mean. I've listened to a few of this stuff, and it may not be for everyone if you're not too keen on the use of some shouting and language. It might not be for you, but give it a go. You never know. You might be on something new by the end of it. What are his live show like? Is there anything that you say something is unique about Frank when he plays live?
He's a great showman. Like, I've only seen him twice, however... He's amazing, just live.
I've heard he really connects with the audience.
Really,
he really gets into working with the audience and putting on such a great show. Full of energy as well.
Yeah, I don't know how he does it, to be honest, for like the 2 hour set that was. It was crazy.
Okay. Where did you go and see him?
So it's the O2 at the Manchester Academy.
All right. And was there a reason you went to Manchester to see him?
I had a gig booked the next again day.
All right.
That they announced earlier in the year, and then Frank Carter came out with his, and it landed on the same day for the Glasgow show. Next again day, so it was like, right, it was Manchester, Manchester or Ali Pali, and I thought Manchester's closer. So,
have you been to many gigs in Manchester before?
That was my first one.
So, when you went looking about trying to understand about the venue, was there anywhere that you could go to find information or stuff you wanted, or was that missing?
That was missing, I'm not going to lie. When I had a look on like Google or whatever, it was kind of very limited. You got their own website for to at least see size of venue and stuff. There was nothing like about of where you can park.
Who does a decent burger nearby? Don't use
exactly,
this kebab shop.
Exactly.
If only there was a website for that, that would be quite useful.
Ticket Punks.
We'll pay you later for that. Buddy, don't worry. So how was the gig?
Fantastic.
Yeah? What was the big highlight for you? What can you take away going, oh wow, I was so glad I saw that at this gig?
I've got to say, the support beforehand, there was two supports, so it was Cleopatra and a band called Horror. I've got to admit, Horror were fantastic.
Oh wow.
I've never seen them play at all. I've never even heard of them. Well, any of those two beforehand. But once I seen Horror, it was like, wow.
For me, that's sometimes the best thing about a gig is catching a support act that you never thought you'd see or you'd never heard of before.
Exactly.
I was at a recent gig going to see Ginger Wildheart in Glasgow, and supporting Ginger was Lauren Tate from Hands Off Gretel.
All right. Yeah.
I'd never heard of Hands Off Gretel before, but if you get a chance, they're touring the UK now. Small independent punk band, really worth going to see. Really good band, and if I hadn't have been there early for that gig, I would never have heard of these guys.
Yeah.
But really glad I went now. Cracking wee band, and I think they're going to do something in the future.
Yeah.
But they're worth going to see. So if you got a chance to see them.
No, I'm always like, as soon as I go to a gig, it's always, I'd need to see the support just in case. Like, for example, find new bands to listen to.
That's it. So you talked about this Horror, so you'll be looking into them, I take
it. Yeah, exactly.
See how they go. That's cool. And was there anything that you thought about the gig that wasn't good? Was the venue all right?
compared to my last Frank Hart, like, I would say the venue was worse, but not overly, like, terrible. All it was right. Just some of the sound quality was a bit not as great.
Yeah. Do you go to many gigs outside of Scotland?
Not unless it's Frank Carter or yeah. Frank Turner, then yeah. No.
The two Franks. I quite the often get Franks, the two confused, yeah. To be honest. I do quite often get them confused. I have to try and remember which one's which. Who did that? That's, so this one. Now, there's some other interesting things about Frank that some people may not know. And it's something that you and I have got a wee bit in common. Yeah. We talked about just tattoos. As you were coming in. Tattoos. So Frank's a tattoo artist, is that right?
Yeah, he's been doing it for quite a while, but he's recently only opened up a shop down in London for his, right. I think it's called Rose of Mercy.
Right.
And he does like his own custom tattoos. Uh-huh. You just email him and hope to get an appointment, yeah. But
I suppose it's going to be a big waiting list.
Hope for that, yeah.
It could be something for the future, though. Keep it on your bucket definitely. List. Definitely. How many times have you seen Frank then?
So that was twice. That was my second time in Manchester, and my first one was in the Liquid Rooms in Edinburgh.
Oh, wow. That must have been great. That's fantastic. Not the biggest venue, so that would have been a great place to see him.
BBC Scotland did a live recording of that show as well.
Oh, brilliant. Have you managed to get a copy of that?
I don't, legally. But they posted on YouTube at least, I think, the Crowbar video.
Ah, right.
I can't tell if I'm in it. It's one of those ones where it's like moving constantly.
The Liquid Rooms can get quite packed as yeah. Well, so it can be quite rammed when you're seeing bands in there. It's a great place to go and catch gigs. So who's next on your agenda then, Billy?
Frank
who's
Turner,
next?
The Frank. Other Frank.
The next Frank.
Yeah, next
all right, and where's that one?
Barrowlands.
Oh, that'll be great.
So can't wait for that one.
Another electric frontman, though, to be honest. He's meant to be really good live as well.
He's
really
focused on it. I've never been disappointed yet with the two Franks, anyway.
We'll need to line up another Frank for you.
I know.
Unfortunately, Frank Sidebottom, Frank Zappa, and Frank Sinatra are all out the
window.
They're
all gone.
So we're going to have to find a new one. If anyone knows of a new Frank that Billy can go and see, drop us a comment, please. This is an appeal for Billy. Let's find Franks. Okay. Now, so are there any other gigs you're looking forward to this year?
I've got the Wild Hearts coming up.
Have you? Where are you going to see them?
It's Gala Shields, 1st of May.
So I'm going to the Stirling Tollbooth one.
The Stirling one, yeah.
So my daughter has been a huge fan of Ginger and the Wild Hearts for years,
yeah.
But she's only just turned 14. So this will be her first proper Wild Hearts, although she was at Ginger and the Sinners in Glasgow. I don't know if you made that one.
No, I don't think I did.
That was in December. That's where we caught Lauren Tate.
Yeah.
That was quite a good gig, but it was a bit more country. It wasn't quite the full-on Wild Hearts experience. But their new stuff sounding great.
That's brilliant.
New live album coming out as well. They released info about that.
Dad sent me a link last night for the vinyl. I'm like, God, I'm going to buy another one.
I know. We're mugs for it, to be honest, but it's usually worth it. There'll be something great in there. Is there anything else that you've got coming this year then, or anything?
Sadly not, that's the last one.
No. Who would you like to see that you've never had a chance to see yet?
Slipknot, definitely. Slipknot. I've never seen them.
If you've not caught episode 2, try and find us and watch episode 2. Neil and his special guest, the Pitrol, make mention to a gig in 2015. I think was that the one that I was there as well? I can't remember if that was the one. Might have been later on that I went to see them and it was worth it. There's no other band that puts on a show like that.
Aye.
To be honest, it's worth going to see, so keep an eye out. I'm sure you'll be able to get tickets to a future gig. But I can't think of I think this year I'm lucky enough I'm getting to go and see Rage. I think Neil's mentioned this in the previous videos. We mentioned this in the first one. That's a band that's going to tick off my bucket list, and I'm praying upon all things that Primus will come over to the UK as well. And they're a very old band from the 90s that are a bit weirder, and I'd love to see them. That's the one band I've got left I'd really love to see that I've never seen yet. But thanks for taking the time, Billy. Thanks for coming in to speak to us. Everybody, thanks for watching. If you've not subscribed already, please do. We're going to have loads more people coming in to talk to us about gigs, what they're finding. We're going to have loads of info in the community. For the price of a coffee, you can join our community. We can give you loads of information about pre-sales coming up. We're hoping to build up some great info about gigs you can go to, so Billy could go in and see in Manchester where he'll get a great kebab or a great pint of beer after a gig, what taxi companies are a bit of a rip-off and which ones to use. All you have to do is look for Ticket Punks. We're on all the socials. We have our own sites. Look us up. You'll find out more about us there. And until then, we'll see you next time. Thanks.